Barbara, I've been very lucky to get to know you better over the last few years. Mm-hmm. I think you have many superpowers, but one that sticks out for me is your forever young attitude. Mm-hmm. How do you stay so young and fresh and fun?
Well, I kind of cheat. You know, I have my mother's genes. She raised 10 kids on a shoestring budget. I never saw her sleep. She did 12 loads of wash a day, ironed the clothes, and was always smiling. Mm. So I got her genes. Let me tell you, that's two-thirds of it right there.
Hmm. Interesting perspective there. What financial strategies, Dolph, in what you're doing for people as a financial professional, which ones do you suggest for folks who do feel young and plan on enjoying a pretty long retirement?
Well, I'm with you. Shark Tank's a great show, and it's a great opportunity for people that are not heard of. And Barbara's wonderful. I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, I'm not 100%, but she made most of her money in real estate. Isn't that correct?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, and she was like a guru of taking little places and just turning it into tycoons. So she obviously she's not personally worried about running out of money.
Right.
But one of the facts is in most studies that you do that running out of money is one of the biggest retirement fears out there. And one of the biggest things that costs that is called healthcare. I mean, when you get out there with your money, things in this world that you don't want to have, Kristen, and you can do this in any aspect you want to, I call it the big three: fear, risk, and stress. All these can do nothing but hurt you and hurt your health. Mm-hmm. I mean, fear of losing your job or losing a loved one, stressful. Risk of losing money in the market or losing money in your portfolio, stressful. The stress of paying for health care and paying bills every month, stressful. I mean, stress is the biggest one out there. And what does stress do, according to doctors? It can raise your heart rate. Nothing good can come out of it. You can agree or disagree with me. But when it comes to your portfolio, when it comes to all this, if you could take a lot of stress off your table, why would you not want to? Why would you not take the chance of finding out, how is this possible? I mean, when was the last time you actually sat down and did an actual life plan with you, your spouse, your husband, a financial advisor, anything? When was the last time you sat down instead of watching Shark Tank for that hour that you watch it every night on a rerun on TBS or whatever it is, and just take that hour and sit down and say, honey, let's talk about our finances. Let's talk what we're going forward for. No, I heard this guy's on here. He's going to talk about a new hat that can pour this, that, and the other on it. No, okay, fine. And then you have a dinner, and the next thing you know, you're going to bed, and boom, guess what that's called? It's called procrastinating. Mm. And when you procrastinate, nothing good can happen out of that. And procrastination can bring fear. Procrastination creates risk, and procrastination gives you stress because you have an issue. One of the issues might be, where's my funds going to come from? Which is going to be creating a problem. Now, my problem now from the issue is, where am I going to have enough money to live on? Where's it going to come from? Now you have a concern, which is starting to become a risk and a fear. Oh boy, I'm not going to have enough money to retire on. I'm going to have to work longer than I want. I need to find a solution. So when you find that solution, you have to make a commitment to that solution. But if you don't make a commitment to that solution, you start all over again. Now that issue has become a major concern, a major problem, and hence your stress gets more. You start making mistakes. You start getting aggressive in the market. You start getting aggressive in the market, a correction happens, and now you're sitting back at ground zero going backwards going, what do I do now? And all this started out because you didn't want to take that 1 hour or 2 hours a week, or excuse me, a month even, and plan for the future.